San Francisco State University Finance 372 Prologis, Take 11, in action.
All right, so we are doing our evaluation on Prologis, whether we should sell the stock, and we believe that we should. We're going to go over the background, financials, stock evaluations, and recommendations. The background, most important thing is that it is public. Now, I don't think we have to go through any of this. The core values is impact, integrity, mentorship, passion, accountability, courage, and teamwork. They really put a lot of value into their team and their employees, which in turn keeps their talent. I think their products are industrial, warehouses, office, mixed use, and they service by with leasing management, logistics, research, acquisitions and development, and raising capital. Here's the C-suite, and we have the CEO right here, who's also one of the founders. Then our SWOT analysis. We think that their strengths is that they're one of the global leaders. They're geographically diverse, and concentrating on the most important, their threats are the global slowdown, causing a recession, and the credit markets crisis.
And I'll take over with the rankings. So you all know Prologis, they're number one. They have a market cap of $28.1 billion. And then we have Duke Realty Corp, Liberty Property Trust, DC Industrial Trust, and then the First Industrial Realty Trust. Also for the financial conditions, equity ratios and growth rate over a three-year range. We concluded with the overall of their average. We use PE, dividend payout, revenue, operating income, and then earnings per share net growth. We did profitability and leverage ratio. So overall average as well. We did technical analysis. So we did a trend line support and resistance. There's an upward trend, also a high volume, especially down here. We came with a target value of 56, which is a premium at 1.3%. Also for a perpetuity model, we used a PEPM. And then also we went ahead and completed with an intrinsic value of 40.43, which is a discount at 26.84. And then for our guarding growth, we went ahead and used the same CAPM. And down here, we went with the 8% rate and then the 2% growth, which led to an intrinsic value of 47.17, which also is a discount at 14.64.
Once again, I apologize for my attire. So here are the listed peer groups with the multiples. And we selected the PE ratios of 18, 19, and 20. And we selected an intrinsic value of 53.77 from the funds from operations of 2018 for $2.83 with a growth rate of 3%. And the DCF model, we used a buyback of 6%. And we used the growth rate from 2018 to 2022, ranging from 6.3% to 3% with a terminal value of 57. And we ended up with an intrinsic value of 51.19 and selected a WACC of 5. And for the net asset value, we ended up with a discount rate of 12.6%, net operating income of $1.4 billion, shares outstanding from 550 million. And for this one, we selected the cap rate of 5% with an intrinsic value of 49.9 cents. For the bracket, for the weights, we selected the middle column because we put the most emphasis on DCF and multiples. And in the end, it gave us an intrinsic value of 50 and 57. And we gave it a sell recommendation. And the discount rate was at 9.3% from the current value of 55.26. And we have a recommendation of full trades, stock sell, sell short by calls, ETF sell, sell short by calls by puts. And indices, right forwards, right features, right calls on features, and right puts on features. And these are our references.